हेलो, मैं हूँ शालिनी हुबलीकर और मेरे चैनल में आप सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है। आज मैं अपलोड करने जा रही हूँ 8 स्टैंडर्ड के बच्चों के लिए फर्स्ट मैथमेटिक्स रैशनल एंड इरेशनल नंबर्स पार्ट 1। तो जो बच्चे आज पहली बार मेरा चैनल देख रहे हैं, उन्होंने सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है मेरे चैनल को, तो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और बेल का आइकन टैप करना मत भूलिएगा, क्योंकि जो मैं लाइव स्ट्रीम करती हूँ उसका नोटिफिकेशन आपको सब्सक्राइब करने के बाद ही मिलेगा, तो आपका बहुत बड़ा नुकसान हो जाएगा। और जो भी आपके डाउट है आप लोग लाइव स्ट्रीम में ऑन द स्पॉट क्लियर कर सकते हैं, ठीक है। तो फटाफट सब्सक्राइब कीजिए, बेल का आइकन टैप कीजिए, लाइक कीजिए मेरी वीडियोज़ को और फॉरवर्ड कीजिए अपने दोस्तों को और रिलेटिव्स को। तो चलिए फिर हम लोग शुरू करते हैं रैशनल एंड इरेशनल नंबर्स।
So today we are going to study rational and irrational numbers. Okay, let's recall. We are familiar with natural number, whole number, integer and rational number. So now what are natural number? Natural number are those number which start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 till it goes to infinity. And whole number are those number which start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So difference between natural number is it start from 1 and difference between whole number is it start from 0. Okay. Now what are integers? Integers are those number which include negative and positive numbers including 0 are called integers. Here from infinity if we count from infinity to minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and till it goes infinity, till infinity. Okay, now we can't count that value. Okay, so this is an example for you to understand. Now what are rational number? Rational number are those numbers, the number of the form m upon n are called rational numbers. Here m and n are integers, but n is not 0. We have also seen that there are infinite rational numbers between any two rational numbers. Okay, now let's go ahead. Let's learn to show rational numbers on a number line. Let us see how to show 7 upon 3, 2 and minus 2 upon 3 on a number line. Now, how we would show these numbers on a number line? So, there is a trick. Okay, now let us go ahead. Now, in the numerator, here is 7 upon 3. So what do you mean by the denominator 3? The denominator 3 means there should be 3 divisions of a single segment. Okay. Now if here it is 3, 7 upon 3, then you will divide this line into 3 parts. So see here, 1, 2 and 3. Yes? 1, 2 and 3. Okay. If here they have given 4, then we will divide it into 4 parts. Okay. And we will make in between 3 parts. Yeah, okay. Alright. And what about the numerator? The numerator means we count from 0. See here. Where they had done 7 upon 3. 7 upon 3 is done 1 from count from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Therefore, 7 upon 3 comes here. Okay. Now, we have to find minus 2 upon 3, where minus 2 is a negative term. So, it will be on the left side. Now, what does minus 2 mean? Minus 2 doesn't mean this. Okay. Now, minus 2 means count from 0, 1, 2. Therefore, minus 2 upon 3. Okay, this is the rational numbers. Now, we have seen the example of rational number here. Okay, now let's go ahead. We can show the number 2 on a number line. 7 upon 3 is equal 7 into 1 upon 3. Therefore, each unit on the right side of 0 is to be divided in 3 equal parts. The 7th point from 0 shows 7 upon 3, or 7 upon 3 is equal to plus 1 upon 3. Hence, the point at 1 upon third distance of unit after two shows 7/3. Okay, now let's see ahead. Two show -2/3 on a number line. First we show 2/3 on it. The number to the left of 0 at the same distance will show the number -2/3. Okay, as I show you, but they have told us in a complicated way. They have told to count on the right side, then you will find 2/3. Then count the same on the left. -2/3, you will find the same. But it's too complicated to understand for the children in standard 8. Okay, so I have explained you in very easier way. Okay, so now we will go through practice set 1.1. Okay, now they are telling us, show the following numbers on a number line, draw a separate number line for each examples. Now they have given us the example, so I have shown you on the example previously, so you will solve it like this only. So this is 3/2, then you will make one dot between two dots. Okay, so this is the gap between 0 and -1 and 0 and 1 between. So now this is the gap, so they have told 2, so we have to divide this part into 2 parts. So we will only draw one dot here. Okay, forgot about this 2 dots for now. Okay, so we will draw only one dot because they have given us 3/2, so we have to draw only one dot and divide the segment into 2 parts. Okay, now done. Now you have to solve such examples like this only. So here 3/2, then from 0 you count 1, 2, 3, then you will find, then you put the mark. Okay, now let's go ahead to solve this example like this only. It will be too easier for you to understand. Okay, observe the number line and answer the questions. Now let us see the number line first. Okay, then see the question. Which number is indicated by point B? Now tell me which number is indicated by point B. First of all, let us count the denominator. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then let us count the numerator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the number B denotes, the number B indicates 10/-10/4 on a number line. Okay, so see how easy is it. Now which point indicates the number 1/3/4? Now let us see. 1, 1, 2, 3/4. Okay, as you know, they have told 1, so we have to directly count 1 here. Okay, so we will count 1 here, and from 3/4 they have told. So 4 is the denominator, is the gap between such dots, and 1/3 means 1, 2, 3, third dot. Okay, so the point C indicates 1/3/4. Okay, state whether the statement the point D denotes the number 5/2 is true or false. Okay, now let us see what is this. It is true, but we will prove it in a different way. Okay, the number D denotes the number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this is false, but what if I say you this is true? Let us see how it is true. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the numerator would be 10. And what about the denominator? Remember the denominator also. So the gap between these is 4. Therefore 10/4. Then what if we divide 10/4? So Definitely, we will get the answer 5/2. Therefore, it's 2. So, thank you. Next time, we will learn about comparison of rational numbers. Bye. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe.